thank God for this blessed day. Hallelujah. That God has blessed us with. And I just look around and everybody looking so nice. And today I just believe God has got a miracle. Wait on somebody today. When they come in the house of the Lord, you got to be expected to be blessed. Amen. And if we expect it, it's going to happen. It's going to take place in the house. Because God don't want none of us to lead the way we came. But He wants us to lead with every burden, man. Every yoke to snow. Every head lifted up. Hallelujah. Believe in the day, overcome in Jesus Christ. Yeah, I thank God. And I thank God for my Father, but I really thank Him for my Heavenly Father. Hallelujah. Let's give our Heavenly Father. Jehovah Jireh, I provide. Jehovah Nisi, glory. Almighty God. He's got all power in His hand. And now He's given us that power and spiritual authority. Thank God for Jesus. And this morning, we just want to come to the throne boldly. Just come to the altar boldly. And just have a little talk with Jesus. Amen. Falling on good ground to bring forth good fruit for your glory. Somebody say it in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. While you're still standing, just turn with me to Romans 8 chapter and 15 verse. Romans 8:15. Glory be to God. This is a different Father's Day's message than I normally preach. But the Lord would have for you to know today that you have a Father.
Oh yeah.
He won't let you to know today that you got a Father who knows all, sees all, He all.
Thank you, Father.
Can do all, they got all power.
Amen.
Somebody say all power in His hand. He wants you to know today that you got a Father who loves you, cares about you, and that you always on His mind. Says Sheila, the Lord told me today that you're always on His mind. He said that if you obey Him and serve Him, you spend your days in prosperity and your years in pleasure. Come on, give God a hand. Thank you, Lord. Now God who sees all, He all know all, see all, and got all power in His hand. Got a God that loves you. He loves you. Your dad loves you. Yeah, He loves you. Care about you. Hallelujah. And here in Romans 8 and 15, for we have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear. But you have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, which means Father. Somebody say Daddy. Father. Yeah, 16, the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, the Spirit itself bearing us witness with our spirits that we are the children of God.
Hallelujah.
And if children, then heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ. If so be that we suffer with him, that we may also be glorified together.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And we're going to use for a topic today, sons and daughters of Almighty God.
Hallelujah.
Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
A neighbor.
Neighbor.
I'm a son.
I'm a son.
A daughter.
A daughter.
Of Almighty God.
Almighty God.
Come on, give God some praise. Yes, that's what he wants us to know today. He wants us to know who we are. He wants us to know who we are in him.
Yes.
Hallelujah. He wants us to know that we've been born again.
Amen.
Glory be to God. Because there's so many of us today, we don't really know who we are. And on down in this chapter right here, it said that the whole world is waiting for the manifestation. That's talking about the coming out.
All right, you guys.
The whole creation is everything waiting. God waiting. The trees waiting. The birds waiting.
All right, you guys.
Everything waiting on us. Waiting on us to reckon somebody. I'm a child of Almighty God. You know, the Bible tells us the way a man thinketh. A man. So as a man thinketh. So we got to quit thinking. Come on,
come on.
We got to quit thinking that we haven't been born like we just a natural woman or a natural man up on this earth. We got to change our thinking.
Amen.
To who this Bible says we are.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. God wants us to know today that Bible, Genesis 1:26 says that God made him just a natural man. I'm not just walking around here, dude. I used to be, but I've been born again. The Corinthians say that if any man or a woman in Christ, then on the outside, when I saw myself as nothing, I behaved. Once I started hearing the Bible, once I got filled with the Spirit started showing me that this ain't no, the Bible not no fairy tale. But that Bible is real. But Satan tried to keep you thinking it's a fairy tale. He don't want you to get in and get a revelation of what you walking in. You walking in authority. You walking in power, more than you. You want God gave it to you. Hallelujah. Jesus gave it to you.
Yes, he did. Thank you.
Come on, man. Amen. And once I start seeing myself as the one with power, and the devil didn't have no authority over me, then I started walking like God. I started getting in that Bible, learning the word of God, and start thinking like God. Start talking like God. I started to turn out what greater is he that's in me than he that's in the world. When I come up against depression, devil trying to put depression on me. Trying to put word, trying to put habits on me. I start talking to the devil. And I believe that Bible.
Amen.
I have to come and believe that Bible.
Amen.
When they say in Isaiah 54 that no weapon, no matter what the devil tried to come after me with, I know he's gonna come out of he gonna come after me to steal, kill, and destroy.
Amen.
He don't want to see me prosper.
Amen.
He don't want to see me be an overcomer.
Amen.
He don't want me to win. He don't want me to walk in the victory. He don't want me to have good success. He don't want me to be happy. He don't want me to be joyous. He don't want me to be free. But the devil is a liar. Name of Jesus.
Amen.
Come on.
Amen.
And I have inherited that name.
Amen.
No matter what I'm going against.
Yeah.
I'm somebody today.
Oh, yeah.
In Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. The Bible says we become a new creature.
Amen.
Over in 2 Corinthians 5:17.
Yeah.
And they go on down and they tell us now. God have given us a ministry to reconcile to God.
Amen.
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 We was away from him, but now we've been reconciled.
Amen.
And now he has given us a ministry,
yes,
a reconciliation,
yes,
to go out and tell somebody about the love of the Father.
Yes.
By God so loved the world that he gave his only son.
Yes.
And that's just not a saying, but that's the truth.
Amen.
That's just how much he loves me. That's just how much he loves you. He gave his own child to suffer and die so that you could be free. Said over in, I believe, Matthew 7, he told us, say, now, when you pray, you ain't got to go to him. You can come boldly.
Yeah.
Come boldly to the throne of grace,
right,
and you'll find help in the time of day.
Oh, yeah.
And just talk to him.
Thank you for the word.
Just say, Our Father.
Yeah.
Our Father.
Yeah.
Which art in heaven. Your holy, hallowed be thy name. Let thy will be done and thy kingdom come on earth as it is in heaven. Somebody said, ain't nothing but joy up there.
Ain't nothing
but peace up there. Ain't nothing but happiness up there. How many of y'all want that down here? Yeah. And amen for us to have. Glory be to God. Here, I'm going to give y'all a few scriptures to meditate on, to just let you know who you are in Christ. You're a new creature now. You're born again with the Spirit of Almighty God living in you. He said, know you not that your bodies are the temple of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. And he lives in us. Yeah. He tells us over here in 1 Peter 2:9. Turn there. 1 Peter 2:9. I want to give you something like this so you can meditate on it.
Amen.
And may God show you who you are. And that you don't have to take mess off of Satan no more.
Okay.
That you can rebuke that devil in Jesus' name.
Jesus.
You got the power.
Amen.
You, somebody said, I got the power.
I got the
authority.
I got the authority.
Yeah, the whole world just waiting for the manifestation.
Yeah.
Of the sons of God. It just waiting on us to start coming up and do things like God did. And he did it by his word, and he did it by having faith in his word. And all we got to do is use the word of God with faith, believing that what God promised, just like Abraham.
Come on now.
Don't make no difference how long it takes. But we are fully persuaded that what he said is going to come to pass. How many of y'all believe that today? Just as he said, tell them if they'll obey me and serve me, they'll spend their days in prosperity and the years in pleasure. Somebody said, you can't beat that. You can't beat that. I'm talking about a good life, victorious life. We have an inheritance. And if we be Christ, we are an heir.
Amen.
And a joint heir. We inherit all things through Jesus Christ.
Yes, Lord.
Okay, let's look at 2 Peter. 2 Peter 2 and 9, if I can find it here. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Somebody got that? 2 Peter 2 and 9. Thank you, Jesus. I'm getting it. I'm just a little slow. 2 Peter.
Amen.
1 Peter, that's why I can't find it. That's why. Satan don't want us to get it. Yeah. Say what?
Don't get it.
Yeah, 2 Peter 2 and 9. 1 Peter 2 and 9. My Lord. Well, anyway.
You are a chosen generation.
Yeah.
You are a priesthood, the holy
nation.
Yeah. Your own special people that you may proclaim the praise of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Amen. How many of you know you're chosen?
Amen.
Somebody raise my hand up. Raise your hand. Say, I'm chosen.
I'm chosen.
By God.
By God.
To be his child.
To be his
son. To be his daughter.
Amen.
He said that you're a chosen generation. A holy nation. Royal priesthood.
All right,
huh? How many of you know you're royalty? See, the way a person think, so is he. Now, if we get that word of God and believe that word of God, he said royalty. Who am I to call him a liar? But Lord, you just don't know who I am. I ain't got nothing on Pope. I'm black. I just don't believe I'm royalty. Well, that's who you are.
Amen.
If you've been born again.
Amen.
And you're in Jesus Christ, because he's a king.
Amen.
He is king of kings.
Amen.
And when we become born again, we become his child.
Yes.
And we come into the family. Amen. Now we look at it. And I'm royalty.
Yes.
And I got to start thinking like I'm somebody.
Amen.
I got to start thinking like I'm a king of kings.
Amen.
I got to start thinking like I'm God's child.
Amen.
With power and authority on the inside of me.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That when I pray, God hears me.
Oh, yes.
That God hears and he answers my prayer.
Amen.
How many of y'all believe that today?
Amen.
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 A chosen generation, a holy nation, a royal priesthood.
Amen.
Ought to be something peculiar.
Oh, yeah.
About you.
Amen.
People people ought not to understand why you don't do what they do. Come on here.
Amen.
Somebody said, that's who I am. I'm a child of God.
I'm a child of God.
I was supposed to be fit me.
Amen.
Yeah, I was messed up.
Yes.
I was born again trying to fit into the world, and God had brought me out. He had brought me out. I had been delivered. I had been delivered out of darkness.
Amen.
Into his marvelous light.
Amen.
I wasn't supposed to be fitting. It was trying to fill a square peg in a round hole. Amen. And every time I try to fit in over there in Satan's world, he tried to kill me. Wouldn't want me to get back over to the kingdom of God. But somebody said, God had mercy. He had mercy on me. Glory be to God. He gave me another chance. He gave me another chance to straighten up what I messed up. Start all over again. In the word of God. And the more I heard the word, the more I believed. The more I believed, the more I got faith. Hallelujah. That I'm a child of God. That I'm a son of God. That I can live by faith. That I can call things that be not as though they were. Just like God. When God said, let there be. There was. Come on, he spoke it. And it came to pass. And he made me in his image, and he made me in his likeness to do things the same way he did. By his word. And by having faith in his word. And by speaking his word. And confessing his word. And believing his word. And standing on that word. Scripture said, have faith. Have faith. And whatsoever things you desire, when you pray, believe that you receive, and you'll have them, Rob. Just keep the faith. Keep standing on the word. Keep speaking that word. Stay in the word. Meditate on the word. Day and night. Don't go about what to see. Don't go about what to feel. But just go about what to see. Father.
Oh, yes.
I thank God today for adopting me as his child. Yeah, let's one more verse. Galatians 4. Galatians 4. Thank God for Jesus. He gave, he sacrificed his life. Thank you.
Yeah.
And he looked at me. He paid the price. He didn't have to do it.
Amen.
Yeah, so I could live. Jesus said he come, church, to give us life.
Amen.
That means no way. Somebody said it, didn't
they?
As a man thinking.
Oh, yes.
So is he.
Amen.
He couldn't give us a good life.
Oh, yes.
And it's already been done. You know what our Heavenly Father has done for us already? He's already put in us everything we need.
Yeah, Lord.
To have life. And to have it more abundantly.
Amen.
It's already in us.
Oh, yes, yes.
And just like when Moses come up against the Red Sea. Mm-hmm. But the Egyptian army had him behind.
Amen.
Red Sea in the front.
Amen.
Mountains on both sides.
Yes.
Million people.
Uh-huh.
Where was he going to go?
Yes,
sir. Somebody, it was in his hand.
Amen.
Lord asked him what's in his hand.
Uh-huh.
Nothing but a rock.
Stretch
it out.
Amen. Oh, hallelujah.
Somebody say, I don't know how I'm going to pay my bills.
Oh, hallelujah.
It's already in.
Amen.
What you got to do, you got to get the Holy Ghost and show you how to use what you got.
Amen.
To get what you want.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Come on, use what you got. God has put talents, gifts.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
And all of us.
Yes, yes,
hallelujah.
Thank
you. And all we got to do is develop it.
Yes.
Develop it.
Amen.
Started out small. But when God breathes on it.
Yeah.
When God breathes on it.
Oh,
come on.
Oh,
increase. Yeah, Galatians 4:4. Yeah. He said, but when the fullness of time was come, God made of a woman made under the law to redeem them as us that were under the law, that we might receive the adoption of sons, being adopted into the family of Almighty God. 6, and became, and because you are sons, God has sent forth the Holy Spirit into our hearts, crying, Abba, Father. So, wherefore you are no more a servant, but a son. And if a son, then an heir of God through Jesus Christ. Come on, somebody say my heir. I have inherited his authority. That's important to me. How Satan had me wrapped up, tied up, tangled up in sin. But glory to God. Found out that I had inherited by God's salvation. And that I walked in his power through the Holy Spirit in me. On this earth.
Amen.
And when I found out that no weapon Satan can come at me with can hold me down. No heaven can hold me down. That I'm walking in authority.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And every devil is in front of my feet. I start talking different, Cherokee. I start talking to the devil. But I was bold when I talked. You ain't gonna worry me no more. You ain't gonna depress me no more. know and thank God, Wayne. My daddy, Wayne. And I said, Lord, what are you doing? We realized that blessing. Ain't nobody do you like Jesus.
Ain't nobody.
Jeremiah 33:10 said, call upon him. And he will answer. He'll show you a great amount of
things.
And you won't even know how it happened. Station of the sons of God. And start walking like it. Talking like it. He made us in his image. Made us in his likeness. Scripture says, seek ye first the kingdom of God. And all these other things will be added unto you. Whatever he blessed you with, I don't care if you start out with a love. Give him 10 cents. Give him your time. Give him, he can do more with it than if you can. He gonna bless you.
Oh, yes, he
gonna bless you. He'll open up your woman's hand. Pour you out blessing, you have to bless somebody else. God is good. God is good. Come on, let's give my hand clap again.
Thank you, Lord.
Healing is the children's bread. Healing is the children's bread. And by the name, healing today.
Yeah, Lord.
The Spirit of the Lord is here.
Yeah.
He's here to heal.
Amen.
He's here to deliver.
Amen.
He's here.
Yes, Lord.
He's here to remove burdens.
Yes, Lord. Jesus. Lord,
he's here. If you're troubled today.
Yes, Lord.
If you're troubled today. The Lord don't want you to leave it when you can.
Come on.
Come on, if you're troubled today. Something got to go in Jesus' name.
Yes.
That troubling spirit got to go in Jesus' name. We believe in God.
Your presence, Lord.
We believe. Yeah, we